Daventry was just a few miles to the east. I'd read all about its wonders in my travel books. I couldn't wait to check out its famous fantastical floating island. I could have sworn the parade of hopeful knights was scheduled for the next day. I should have been with them, marching with triumph. It seemed my first few minutes in Daventry were off to a terrible start.
So, how did you catch up with them?
That odd horn seemed to be missing some sort of mouthpiece. The horn was broken, but that didn't stop me from blowing on it.
Leave Triumph.
Don't worry, Triumph can fend for himself. We've been through our share of sticky situations, but he always comes around when I need him most. After all that graceful rappelling, I was certainly not headed back that way. Daventry was just a few miles to the east. I'd read all about its wonders in my travel books. I couldn't wait to check out its famous fantastical floating island. Strange tracks blazed a trail through the forest. That wheel seemed freshly broken. That wheel seemed freshly broken.
Stand back, you dirty thieves! Wah!
Oh, it's just a boy. Don't know where he's from, but it must be hard to pronounce.
You know, you should never sneak up on a guy in a dangerous place like... Oh! What's wrong with your foot?
Probably stepped on a spiniferous thornweed.
Don't worry, I got just the fix for that. Tell me, is it more of a ow or a oh, oh? Either way, the Merchant of Miracles has got you covered. But it'll cost you. I've risked my neck to forge the most rare, miraculous, mysterious, and oftentimes delicious ingredients. Huh, here it is. I massage this into my skin twice a day, and just look at my little biscuits. Well, now that I've mulled it over, you'd better not. It might stunt your growth. Ooh, such exquisite material.
Hey.
Mm-hmm. I knew you weren't from around here. Well, you best get going. Yeah. Nobody likes a late night. Oh, wait. You're stuck here with me. Every bridge in is out. And my shortcut had a few shortcomings. I swear that rock leaped straight out of the water. Now I'm stuck here with no wheel, a lost toolbox, and Mr. Fancy Cakes. Say, what? I'll bet a fine strapping young man like you could help me fix up this wheel. Yep, you help me fix my chariot, and I'll give you a lift to the tournament. Hopefully no one else notices your horrible lack of punctuality. Oh, how rude. Do you have any questions for me?
Nope.
Perhaps there was a wheel on the other side of that river. Too bad I couldn't swim.
How did you get across that river?
Oh, can I pet your goats?
Stay away from my majestic unicorns! Find me a wheel, boy. Anything big and round should do the trick.
The wheel was very broken. I would have to find another solution. I wondered what those birds needed a toolbox for. Shame. The only tool left seemed to be a small hatchet. And no, Gwendolyn, before you start asking me thousands of questions about that hatchet, I did not go around using it on everything. The wheel was very broken. I would have to find another solution.
Seems like a waste of money.
That missing wheel had me stumped. I had to go out on a limb to get past the root of the problem.
Ugh. Grandpa, your infamous puns are not my favorite.
What's the matter? You don't like the timbre of my voice? You'll warm up to the puns.
These are terrible.
Kitty, kitty, not a kitty, not a kitty!
No wheels are there. An overgrown patch of spiniferous thorn weeds obstructed a path to the water well.
The well with the ginormous dragon in it?
Perhaps. I tried to chop down those thorn weeds, but my tiny hatchet was ineffective. I would need a bigger, sharper blade. Square was eerily quiet. Was I the only person in Daventry not at the parade? A bakery. And it smelled delicious. The delectable goods looked tasty, but I couldn't compete in this tournament with a full stomach. Ah, I didn't see any reason why that stale bread wouldn't work for a wheel.
Seems like a waste.
That sign was asking for tips, and there was a metal pan to collect coins. I decided to leave some coins for the bread. I stumbled upon some kind of curiosity shop. Against the knickknacks was a little collection tray with a sign asking for tips. I saved my money for a better opportunity. Nothing seemed to be brewing yet. I thought these potions, herbs, and other magical sundries were best observed from afar. I didn't need to borrow more than one wheel. I didn't need to borrow more than one wheel. Like me, this little tree was new in town and needed some time to grow and find its way. What? Too sappy?
I have nothing to say.
You'll warm up to it. Looked like a blacksmith shop of sorts. That sign was asking for tips, and there was a metal pan to collect coins. I saved my money for a better opportunity. I borrowed enough for the day.
And then you scooped up all the weapons, right? Right?
No, Gwendolyn, I didn't. I was looking for a wheel, not a fight. I borrowed enough for the day.
Hello, could I squeeze by you gents?
No. We are here to guard the town entrance and keep out any riffraff whilst everyone is watching the parade. If we were to leave, rapscallions would run amok in the empty shops.
Back away, boy. We are on the lookout for intruders.
A shortcut.
Do I really have to hear the story about how you took forever to tiptoe across that fallen tree again?
No. I guess not.
You still haven't found that replacement wheel? Hey, I'm not the one that's late for that tournament, you know.
I thought this might do the trick.
Lovely choice, boy. And thank the Yarblesnoofs, this bread is beyond stale. Hopefully it didn't pay too much. You have a face that just screams overcharged. I've got just the fix for that, too. But we have important tournament business to tend to, and I think this'll do the trick. Ooh, I'll just need to start locking my unicorns up at night. Mr. Fancy Cakes has a nibbling problem. All right, off we go. Oh, wait, before my mind slips, I was able to procure an entrance ticket to the tournament. Since you so graciously found me a wheel, I am more than willing to sell it to you at a reasonably discounted rate. Are you interested?
Oh, sounds good. I love a deal.
So do I, boy, so do I. If I see one, I'll let you know. Here you are. Now, let's Vamanusi from this meadowland, Mr. Fancy Cakes. It is go time. Mr. Fancy Cakes! Ah, heel! Halt! Abyss! Stop! We sincerely hope you enjoyed your stay in our luxury cabin. Please gather your belongings and watch your head on exit.
Thanks for the hospitality.
No time to lounge, my boy. Lucky for you, the parade is halted. Another case of a mysterious missing bridge, I imagine. Watch your step. We wouldn't want any tears in that illustrious cape. Bon voyage, Buttercup. Don't forget about us working folk. Especially when your pockets are full of riches.
Back away, back away. This area is unsafe for commoners.
Hello. Apologies, I'm late. I should be on the list. First name Graham, last name...
The list, unfortunately, is inside the theater, which is across that bridge, which is inexplicably missing.
We've ordered a temporary fix, but we're still sorting out the work order.
Well, with all the recent budget issues, I remain skeptical about the repairs.
Well, can't those knights check the list?
Do you mean Kyle and Larry? They're off duty. Don't ask.
You needn't worry. These knight hopefuls will figure out a solution soon, and then we can carry on with the auditions.
Well, but I am a hopeful knight. If you just step aside, I'm confident that I could find a way across.
Daventry Decree 6645 states that a royal guard, once commanded, must never, under no circumstances, abandon his post while on duty.
Well, technically, Addendum 237A allows us to leave if someone is in distress and in need of assistance, of a life or death nature.
I stand corrected, and we wouldn't want a repeat of the Rubenstern fiasco. A tardy auditionee, however, hardly counts for distress. Sorry, but we can't leave our post. King's orders. The forest is blocked until this situation is under control.
Come at me, bees!
Then you chop down the tree full of angry bees?
Enough, Gwendolyn.
Those rocks. It's dangerous. Distress!
Abandon post!
Learn how to swim, boy.
Thanks for saving me.
You're welcome, lad.
He was talking to me.
I believe he was talking.
Stay off those rocks. It's dangerous. Distress!
Abandon post!
Learn how to swim, boy.
Thanks for saving me.
You're welcome, lad.
He was talking to me. His tired argument is getting on my nerves.
No need to argue about the fact that I am... Uh-oh. Oh. Not good.
Well, he was quite the jerk, am I right?
Uprooting a tree. How heroic. Anyone mind if I take five?
Careful. If you fall in, who will save you?
Another horn and another missing piece.
pardon me!
The tree was too heavy to move. I would need to chop it down to size.
And then you chopped down the tree full of angry bees?
Enough, Gwendolyn.
You can't ignore me forever.
I don't mean to be rude, but I'm deep in thought.
The tree was too heavy to move. I would need to chop it down to size. I left the hatchet lodged in the tree because I would not need it any more.
Are you sure?
Quite sure. Everyone always asks about that hatchet. It gets a tad annoying.
A sec. Graham, right?
Yes. How did you know my name?
Well, you'd be surprised at the information people give out when they're too busy thinking about their own agenda. I also observed that without you, no one could have made it across. Well done, Graham.
Thanks, I guess.
They'll never acknowledge it, you know. Those who use their minds over their biceps are never woven into the tapestries of time. I can tell you're like me, a creative thinker, an intellectual. To win this competition, you'll need to prove that your talents are more powerful than their strength, agility, and speed. You'll also need a friend.
I could really use a friend.
They call me Manny. Pleased to meet you.
So, friend, what's your favorite color? Do you like popcorn-flavored jelly beans? Because I do. What's your availability for sleepovers? Are we in a secret club?
Ha 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 ha. Green. I prefer pizza flavored. I'm free on Wednesdays and Saturdays, and I would say more of a secret alliance.
Alliance?
This competition will not be easy, and Daventry needs men like us. If we put our heads together, we might have a shot.
What's the plan?
If you win, put a good word in for me with the king. And if I win, I'll do the same. Soon, we'll both be moving up the ranks in the castle together. We should head inside the theater, though. Let me know how I can help.
Graham, to the front of the stage, please. Now that we have recovered our list, it is my duty to inform you that you are officially signed in. Yay. And I do want to apologize. I am very, very terribly sorry. But we've run out of commemorative tote bags.
That's not a problem. I have no use for tote bags. My mother designed my cape with lots of pockets. Is the next event about to start?
Not so fast, Pocket Boy. The tournament bylaws explicitly state that each contestant must complete every event before continuing on in the competition. Since you were late, you missed the test of chivalry and the welcoming parade, both designed as lighthearted warm-ups and getting-to-know-you type exercises. You know, an icebreaker before we start in on the usual death, destruction, and duels of a cutthroat nature.
Don't forget about Amendment 70, Article 4.
I was getting to that, thank you. In the spirit of equal opportunity, the new rules state that you can schedule a makeup chivalry test if and only if the circumstances for your absence were extenuating. So, I will ask, what were your extenuating circumstances that made you late for the tournament?
Well, I never heard the date was switched.
Mm-hmm. I'll just pencil in hard of hearing. Now, go on, mingle with the other contestants. Find out as much as you can about them, and when you're ready for the chivalry test, come and see me.